number of moles is equal to mass of oxygen in grams by its gram molecular weight. So mass of oxygen in grams is equal to 0.032, whereas gram molecular weight of oxygen is 32. So this 0.03, you have to remove these zeros, you have to divide it with 1000. So this 0.032, it will be 1000 times. That means 1 by 1000, or it will be 0.001 mole. This is the relation between number of moles and weight of the gases. If the mass of the gases are given in other units other than grams, first thing that you have to do is convert that mass into grams. Then you should use the formula, given formula, to get the number of moles. Calculate that how many moles are present in 22 grams of CO2. 22 grams of CO2. Here, let us, molecular weight of CO2 is equal to 44. Molecular weight of CO2 is 44. So here, the same thing is given, but for a different gas, carbon dioxide gas, they are asking how many moles by giving its mass. For any such problems, the same procedure, what you have to do first, you write down the molecular weight of CO2. Write down molecular weight of CO2. What is molecular weight of CO2? Write down molecular weight. Is equal to 44. Then gram molecular weight. Is equal to 44 grams. Then weight of CO2 is equal to 22 grams. So here the mass was given in grams only, so you need not convert it into further units. If it is other than grams, then only you have to convert into grams. Here already given in grams. So now the mass of the gas is given, the molecular weight you know. Then to find out the number of moles, you have to use this formula. The number of moles is equal to mass of gas, here CO2, mass of CO2 by gram molecular weight of CO2. So mass of CO2 is equal to 22. And gram molecular weight of CO2 is 44. So this is nothing but 1 by 2. That is equal to 0.5 moles. Calculate another problem. Calculate the mass of 1.5 mole CaCO3. 1.5 mole CaCO3, atomic weights of Ca is equal to 40, carbon is equal to 12, oxygen is equal to 6. So here the problem is, the number of moles were given and they are asking the mass of the substance in grams. Now here the compound is CaCO3. Molecular weight is not given, but they have given us the atomic weights. Calcium is 40, carbon is 12, oxygen is 16. In CaCO3, in one molecule you have one calcium, one carbon and three oxygens. So by using these molecular weights, atomic weights, you can easily calculate the molecular weight of CaCO3. So molecular weight of CaCO3 is equal to 1 into calcium plus 1 into carbon plus 3 into oxygen atomic weights. So that is 1 into 40 plus 1 into 12 plus 3 into 16. That is 40 plus 12 plus 48. That will be equal to 100. By this way, you have to calculate the molecular weight of the substance. So now we have the molecular weight of CaCO3. So molecular weight of CaCO3 is equal to 100. Then it is very easy to find the gram molecular weight. So then gram molecular CO3 is equal to 100 grams. Then here number of moles were also given, that is 1.5 moles. So number of moles is equal to 1.5. So they are asking for mass of the gas. In the previous problems, they have given us the mass and asked for the number of moles. Here number of moles were given, they are asking the mass of the gas. So if number of moles were given, if they ask us the mass of the gas, you have to use this formula. That is, mass of the gas is equal to number of moles into gram molecular weight. So you have to use this formula to get the mass of the substance in grams. So mass of the gas in grams is equal to number of moles into gram molecular weight. Number of moles into gram molecular weight. Here the number of moles is 1.5. Then gram molecular weight is 100 grams. Then the product is 150 grams. So 150 grams of CaCO3 will be equal to 1.5 mole, or 1.5 mole of CaCO3 weight is 150 grams. Understand? Calculate the mass of 2 moles of KClO3, potassium chlorate, KClO3, potassium chlorate. Here atomic weight of K is equal to 39, Cl is equal to 35.5, and oxygen is equal to 16. So here also they gave us the atomic weights of the elements that were present in the molecule. From it, first what you have to do, to you should find out the molecular weight. In any problems related in this mole concept, first of all the thing what we have to do is to calculate the molecular weight, because they are related with that only. So the molecular weight of KClO3, here in KClO3 molecule you have one potassium atom, one Cl atom, and three oxygen atoms. So this molecular weight is the sum of these all the atoms present in it. That is 1 into atomic weight of potassium plus 1 into atomic weight of chlorine plus 3 into atomic weight of oxygen. So here potassium is 1 into 39 plus 1 into 35.5 plus 3 into 16. That is 39 plus 35.5 plus 48. Sorry, 48. Then the sum of the, all these things are 122.5. So the molecular weight of KClO3 is equal to 122.5, then gram molecular weight. KClO3 is equal to 122.5 grams. Then number of moles is equal to 2. They are asking for mass of the gas. So here we have the formula. The mass of the gas in grams will be equal to number of moles into its gram molecular weight. Here the number of moles is 2. Gram molecular weight is 122.5. So substitute those values here. 2 into 122.5, that is equal to 245. So the mass of 2 moles of KClO3 is 245 grams. So this is the way to calculate the mass of the gas if the number of molecules and its molecular weight is known. Now, sometimes they may ask us the molecular weight by giving the number of moles and its weight. So 0.5 moles of a substance mass is found as 90 grams. What is its molecular weight? Here, the problem is different. The number of moles and mass of the substance, both are given. But they didn't mention the name of that substance, but they are asking its molecular weight. We can calculate without even, we need not know its name. And there is no need of the elements present in it to calculate the molecular weight. Because number of moles were given and mass of the substance was also given. In such cases, you have this formula will be useful for us. That is, gram molecular weight of a substance will be equal to number of moles into its, So now the given, let us note down first the given data. That is, number of moles is equal to 0.5. Mass of the substance is equal to 90 grams. Here you should be very careful regarding the unit, whether it is grams or milligrams or kilograms. So here it is grams, so you need not worry about it. So mass was given in grams and number of moles were also given. Then this formula will be useful for us to calculate its molecular weight. So gram molecular weight of a substance will be equal to mass of the gas in grams by number of moles. Mass of the gas is 90 grams. Number of moles is 0.5. So, if you remove this zero, you have to multiply with 10. Then, 2 times, then 180. So, 180 is the molecular weight of the substance. If 0.5 mole of that substance mass is 90, the molecular weight of the substance is 180. Next.